He's our favourite television judge and one of my favourite people. He's stepped away from the courtroom for his new topical comedy show, The Rob Rinder Verdict.
But more importantly, he every summer goes to Ibiza with Susanna. And apparently what goes on tour in Ibiza stays on tour in Ibiza. Well, not now, because... Well, Judge, good morning to you, first of all.
Good morning,
Do you
good
like
morning.
To be called Judge, Rob, Mr. Rinder?
Whatever
you want to call me. That's Sir, exactly. Whatever.
What
Especially if you're buying dinner, Piers.
What goes on in Ibiza with Susanna every year? That she disappears, I hear nothing from her.
Right.
All I hear afterwards, I may have fallen off the wagon.
Not really. I mean, we're a bit pathetic, aren't we? I mean, the club that we go to finishes at midnight. It's sort of like a party sponsored by Mumsnet. It's not that cool.
And then every morning we're up early for spin.
We go spinning, we do some exercise, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
And, of course, the best thing is, I mean, just the sex is so good. and you're right on the weekend. The reality is the reason she's just not on the phone is just because we're exhausted, isn't that right?
Did you see the cover of Event magazine?
I did.
Yesterday.
Absolutely right, yeah.
Which I think lends itself nicely to... If we were both single, we'd be at it like stoats in a sack.
You know what kind of animals stoats are. They're vicious, aggressive, territorial.
Yeah, it's a shame.
If you put them in a sack together, they'd kill each other. Isn't that true?
Apparently, female stoats, when they want to mate, when they're sending out a mating signal, they whine a lot. In the proximity of the male stoat.
Yeah.
Right.
So I'm beginning to do the maths and realise this has been a four-year mating course.
Keep deluding yourself, Piers Morgan. Can we talk
that
about
does
the
seem
Rob
like
Rinder
a delusion.
Verdict?
I'm having too much... That does seem like a delusion.
You're in fantastic
Let's
nick,
not go mad
right?
at the moment.
I don't want to say too much, because you'll get overexcited.
Oh,
but
OK.
You are.
Overexcited.
What do you make of this James Corden thing, the obesity thing?
Well,
have
look,
you ever had trouble with your weight in your
life?
Yeah,
I was not comfortable in my body in my 20s, and that's the nicest way of putting it. I started doing exercise, but for me it was about my health and my mental health. Mm. What I'm entirely confident about, and I feel sure you are too, is that nobody was motivated by shame ever to do anything. It has to be...
I don't really agree with that.
Well, you're wrong.
I'm telling you, whether it's smoking or... Well,
I agree with you, Rob.
What is shameful is this country and America currently have appalling, particularly youth obesity. We have the worst youth obesity in Europe in this country. Yeah.
Shaming young people individually is a horrible
approach
to lose weight. Horrible.
Clearly, just ignoring the problem isn't helping either. It's making
you don't
it
have
worse.
To ignore the problem. Yeah, encouraging people to make good choices, good quality choices, doesn't come by telling them that they're terrible. The reality is, and you know this too about anything, what you're sure, well, you're definitely likely to do is make that problem
in
infinitely
sport,
worse.
In sport, which we don't do enough of, and that's part of the problem with obesity in this country, the state schools do not play enough sport. I would have, if I was Prime Minister, I'd bring in an hour a day compulsory sport for everybody, right? But in sport, if you have a weakness, right, the coaches will tell you, that's your weakness, right? You've got to stop doing that. That's terrible. And here's where we're going to help you get to a better place, right? And in a way, people get shamed every day on a sports field and they end up correcting the problem, the weakness.
But there's a difference.
Why don't we take that philosophy to life?
Because there's a difference in improving whatever you're doing in sport, certainly, any of your technique, that sort of thing, and something which is a deep-seated psychological and emotional issue.
I don't agree.
You do, and there are other...
No, I don't.
I
think it's the same principle.
I know that you agree, because I feel confident that, you know, you've got a daughter who's growing up against a backdrop of social media and pressure, etc.
Yeah.
We need to think of a number of things. We need to think about, first of all, where is this perfect body type coming from? Mm-hmm. You know, you watch the brilliant Lizzo go out on stage, and she's a different size body. Secondly, what I absolutely know, and you hear and listen, as I'm confident you do to young people, is you know that when people are shamed, they are told that they're bad, their self-esteem is lowered. What they're more likely to do is act in a way which is unhelpful to them.
Except,
and
okay, let me respond to that. I accept that. I would say I've got four kids and they're all different ages, but whatever age they are, if they have a weakness in their life, I try and help them correct it.
Right.
But I'll do it. A lot of it is by humour and teasing and prodding. You know, like I said, my brothers, when any of us have put on a bit of weight, the others poke the bear, and guess what? It drives each of us to then go and want to...
No, it doesn't drive you to lose weight, though.
No, but I'm saying in
well,
our...
it does. The instant reaction is going to...
No, I won't
want to have a burger.
You can't speak for me and my brothers.
Here's what happens.
You can't. You don't even know my brothers.
As far as I know, I don't know.
Right,
you know?
Here's my point. It does work for us.
It does works work for us. And that's... Listen,
if one of my brothers had a night with you, I'd know about it.
There's a huge... Wait a second.
I know.
I just enjoy him being wrong. You're just wrong.
We all enjoy him being wrong, but let's just park him being wrong.
Here's the thing. I know for sure that you don't even think this stuff.
No, I do.
You absolutely don't. There's no way.
No, it's worse than you think. I do.
No, you don't.
All you've done so far is tell me what I think and what happens to me.
Because he has more faith in you than you have in yourself.
No, but you definitely don't think that if your child found themselves struggling with their weight, as in all likelihood they will, struggling with their identity, or you were concerned that perhaps they were making lifestyle choices and they were eating food which you thought perhaps wasn't healthy, that you think shame would be the way that you would approach that with your own daughter. And if you wouldn't approach that with your own daughter, then you can't espouse the nonsense that you're saying
here. I don't know, but I would say tough love, absolutely. And we have lost the celebration of tough love in this country. We're now... Parents have got weak.
That's a different thing.
And as a result, we now have...
That's a different thing. That's about setting boundaries.
I think parents have got weak in this country with their kids. They have.
Can I just say...
And discipline has become a bad thing. Discipline has become an ugly word.
Discipline is not the same thing as shame. So you've immediately conceded the point, agreed with me, that shame doesn't work, but that discipline might. Now,
let's turn to your... Look, you're on here to talk about your show, not to put
you right. I was having such a nice time.
No, you can come back
anytime. Talking about your show is a nice thing, too. Yeah.
You've gone into the chat show genre.
I love it.
Yeah.
It's great.
Why do you electrocute your lovely mum during the show?
Well, I don't know. She enjoys
bit
it.
Bit of tough
That's
love.
The main thing.
Was it,
yeah.
Bit of poking
I'm
the bear.
Shaming her.
I mean, you talk about me treating my family in a certain way and you electrocute your mother
on air. I want people to be truthful and it's one way of dealing with it. Also, it's only a small electric shock.
And if they say no comment, she gets a little buzz.
She gets a tiny one. I mean, I suspect it's less painful than Botox, so...
OK.
Can you give me one little nugget of life with Susanna in Ibiza?
I've given you the nugget. I've told you what we... You know, it's rampant.
How about... She's rampant.
But just the two and a half. I mean, there you are. It's pathetic. Honestly, it's like Saga Tour of Ibiza. I mean, not that Saga is pathetic. It's wonderful.
Nothing wrong with Saga Tours.
Oh, no, I tell you what, we did go to a Tiny Temper concert, didn't we?
Yes, we did.
And she knows all of the words.
Yeah,
and in fact, you introduced me to female grime artists and why I've become so interested. No,